Hey guys, I'm Janet from Occasion, and today we are taking back Mist Gorge from the Gorges. Amusingly, is this where they're from? Is that why they're called Gorges? Is it because they're the Mist Gorge football team? I'm going to assume so, but I need confirmation on that. I haven't read the Ogre Army book in a while, so I don't remember anything about the football team, but it's fine. You know, we'll assume that's the case, and then we'll correct moving forward. So anyway, Chan Duanmu needs to take this back. I mean, the fact that she's having to run around just fielding, I think is, you know, more sports terms. But also, really interesting. I'm enjoying this. So losing this place, yeah, fine, whatever. We'll take it back. And now we've defeated a bunch of armies that wouldn't come and fight us before. It's pretty great. It's kind of win-win. But I am going to fight this, I think. Because I feel like, actually, I do kind of want to get on with the whole chaos stuff. You know what? We'll auto resolve this one, and we'll try and ambush some... ogres later. So let's just go ahead and take this. And now we've just ruined the balance again. Okay, that's... Why is it this building? Get out of here. Okay, so that's interesting to know. So if you take over any land, the auto-conversion will convert to the Yang building, by the looks of it. Because we actually had the Yin building here. And then it got taken over. It would have been converted into an ogre version of this building. And then when we took it back over, it converted back into it, but to that one. That's interesting. That's interesting. So we have to prioritize Yang being the one that we take. So that would explain why, I guess with Confederation actually though, that shouldn't be the case, should it? I don't know. Although I suppose some of the territory we've taken over there belong to Skaven or, you know, Greenskins or other Skaven. So that could be why. We seem to be deleting Yang buildings far more often, because it could be that our allies have had the same problem where they've taken over territory, and then it's suddenly been a Yang building, where they may have built a Yin building. That's interesting. Interesting to keep in mind. So either through natural skill or the benefit of experience, this one has an admirable ability in taking the fight to their foes. You sure do. Now let's level you up. Let's get. Oh, I don't know, earthing? Oh, might of heaven and earth. Let's max this out. So we can actually overcast this, which just seems insane. What's the overcast version do? It says greater effect on melee attack and damage. This happened with other spells as well. We have to check the actual ability. That's all 25%, and that is also... And that's 50% for everything. I'm on the wrong thing. And that's 50% for everything. So yeah, the pips aren't showing level 1 and level 2 like they're supposed to. Even though it should. Oh, no, they're still saying upgraded. Oh, that's weird. That's very weird. The pips aren't quite showing what they're supposed to. That's very odd. In Warhammer 1, it would show you what each tier of spell did if you hovered over the pips. This seems to be very strange. Never mind. Well, we're taking that over. I just realised you got a bunch of level ups then. Okay then, let's get Sure Aim, I suppose.
A gift from my ancestors.
And for you, you probably got a bunch of level ups too, didn't you? Nope, just the one. Aw, bless him. God, we need to get Astromancers, I've just realised. I'm pretty sure Astromancers have the increased replenishment. I think they do, right? I mean, it's easy enough to check. Hey, Miao Ying. And nope, scouting. No replenishment. What gives a replenishment bonus then? Possibly nothing. Well, how about that? So Kaidos Fateweaver is busy trying to protect Floating Mountain. It looks like the Poxmakers of Nurgle are actually nearby too. Interesting. Interesting. I have to take the fight to them at some point. Nah, probably not. So, do I take this territory over? It's actually only... Oh, okay, that's very strange. What's going on here? How is that wasteland, but everywhere else around here is chaotic wasteland? That seems very peculiar to me. Just one little spot in the middle just isn't quite as terrible to live in as everywhere else. Is it because, like, it's the same sort of landscape as the Mountains of Morn? Could be.
The Emperor's
Wait, what?
Daughter.
You still think you're going over there? That was the other end of the rift that she was in. That's very odd that it's decided that that's where she's going. Anyway, Floating Mountain. We're going to go take this out. We're going to kill Kairos. Floating Mountain doesn't have a big garrison. And we are going to fight this, because I think it'll be an interesting fight, because it's in a map that we wouldn't have fought before, because we haven't fought in the Chaos Wastes before. As, you know, as Miao Yin at least. I have in other campaigns, but not this one. So let's do it. And here we are. Wow, this is cool. So this is actually an ogre. So I was right. This is sort of an extension of the Mountains of Morn, because this is actually an ogre kingdom's settlement. But the scenery surrounding is very chaos wastesy. All these huge, Sky Titan ruins everywhere. Giant Sky Titan aqueduct. But, I mean, clearly not the friendliest place in the world, is it? This is awesome. See, now this I love. I mean, the sky is such a simple thing for them to change. And I guess the floor textures have changed a little bit, I think. It's hard to tell. It's honestly a bit hard to tell. But a lot of these mountains look a bit more Kislev-y somehow compared to previous battle maps we've done, you know? It's not like the big brown sort of sandstone rocks and things. So it's kind of amazing at this level of variety with the different settlement options. This really does feel like the same culture, but in a different location, like really nicely. It really does have a good, like, I don't know, it just has a good bearing on where in the world you're fighting, and it really conveys that information better. Because this really does feel, from what we've seen in the Mountains of Morn, this feels like how things would be if you travelled just that little bit too far north in the Mountains of Morn. It really is amazing. I'm really impressed by how they do this.
Stand together,
bloody marvellous. So you two are going to charge in as the vanguard. Spells are going to be incredibly useful, and all of our celestial dragon crossbowmen are going to do terrible, terrible things to everybody. We also have you lot. Not really sure what to do with these guys, but they look incredible. I love them. I love my little chocobos. They're brilliant. Good boys. Okay. So you know what? You two are going to stand to one side for a minute. You two.
My test begins.
And I'm going to lock you lot together. Move you forwards. I'm going to charge right in with you. And Spawn of Tzeentch. And, alright, horse with throwing axes. I actually want to avoid. They got that armor piercing. So yeah, we'll let our celestial dragon crossbowman do all the work.
Ready to defend.
Okay. Now, what can I start throwing spells at? God, look at this. Kairos Fate Weaver. Tell you what I can do. Missile mirror would be good. Can't use it on him yet. Okay, what's this going to be? Got to be careful of that one. Penundral Pendulum is incredibly overtuned at the moment. No, what? Okay, obviously clicked on that unit. That was very frustrating. Oh well, it'll do. So, they're nearly dead already. They're nearly dead already, which is amazing. Yeah, they're all retreating. None of them want a piece. That's impressive. Alright, we're going to have to start splitting up a bit. So, let's get you guys over here. Alright, you're going to take that area. You lot are going to go here. And, I don't know, you lot can go over here. Good. And then we have some spares. Suits me. I guess you can go here. Sounds good.
The dragon's ass
is what I'm pretty sure he said. Okay, so missile mirror we're not going to use because no one's sticking around. They're all running off. God, there's Doom Knights up here. Look at these guys. How cool are these? Doom Knights are really great. They're like an OG creation for this game, which I think is great. Big fan of them. Alright, so we do have a Wind Blast, but I'm so glad they can't aim those spells properly. I really am. Real happy. Alright, you guys should be able to do some mad work against all these units. Yeah, once you get there. Once you get in place. God, they're all just retreating from us, which is amazing. So you're braced, but that doesn't look like it's going to matter. So there goes that. This is amazing, right? The amazing with the barriers for the Chaos Knights. So they took a volley from each of the Celestial Dragon Crossbowmen before they started taking damage.
Never
which is absolutely awesome. I love that that's the case. Doom Knights are on their way. I mean, this is a bit of a mess, but I'll take it. So you go for those Chaos Knights, and let's keep moving you forwards. Okay, we're going to use Chain Lightning over here, and we'll see how that goes. Pretty good, pretty good. And let's also hit you with a Helmet of Cassandora, even though you probably don't need to. How the hell? Perhaps because you're Doom Knights. And wow, that is no joke. It's still going. Ooh, wow. Wow, Kairos is not mucking about, huh? We should go kill him. Come here, you. You swine.
My mind is ready.
Good. Now let's buff Miao Yin, which I can't seem to click on for some reason. God, the damage these guys can do with their spells. Amazing.
For the Emperor.
This is such a mess. And I love it. I absolutely love it. God, look at this. Alright, you know what? We're using another Chain Lightning. I've decided. We're using another Chain Lightning. On top of myself. Yep, we're winning over there. We're good. We're good. Okay, guys, come on. Come on, you lot. Let's get out of here. Alright, how's everyone doing? You guys can move up. In fact, all three of you can move up. And you guys can move in as well. There we go. You can keep killing Kairos. And things are looking a bit grim for you, aren't they? Alright, Comet Cassandora. And once that's triggered, I'll use the Potion of Toughness. Okay, good. And we'll throw in some lightning for good measure. Awesome. God, what a mess. Let's keep moving through, huh? And, okay, yeah, we've done some amazing damage over here.
Dragon Guard.
Okay, Dragon Guard, come on. Move you in. God, you're taking some damage, huh? So we've always got Kairos again. Almost. And our Terracotta Sentinel is doing great.
Mage of the Celestial Court.
Doing really well. Yep, there he goes. And everyone started to grumble. That's army losses. And all the... Oh, okay, the Chaos Spawn will be in here for a little while longer, that's for sure. They don't go anywhere. And oh, wow, look at that. You see this? Nobody managed it anyway. Okay, that spell effect there. That's because Kairos tried to cast a spell. But no, he's probably this jerk. Come here, you. Little swine. Oh, well. Died before I got to him. And they hit me with another one of these. Celestial Dragon Guard getting absolutely butchered by spells. I'm amazed how much damage these do. It really is astounding. Okay, come on, guys. Finish those spawn of Steam Chuff, yeah? Yeah, I might actually be down some units of Celestial Dragon Guard. And if I don't take over the settlement, I'm going to miss out on a turn of replenishment. But that's crazy. The damage they've done with spells. Incredible. Brilliant. And no, we didn't use the Griffites. I know. Alright, before you all comment. I know I didn't. Would have been quite handy, though, for dealing with those backline threats. But I didn't think of them. Because I just don't think of Griffites when I think Cathay. Like, the fact they're so unique just means they were just at the back of my mind. Just didn't think of them at all. So I'll have to be more careful about that in future. Just really, you know, yeah, we have Griffites. I know, it's a novelty. We need to use them. But yeah, I'm just on autopilot with the units that I have. I don't think of using... it's just a tool in the tool belt that I don't think of. But yeah, we're going to have to break that habit. Or else they're going to be sat idle a lot. Just you wait, they're going to be sat idle a lot. So yeah, we're going to have to occupy this.
Your rule will be.
Which is very annoying. Or else we're going to end up with another turn of attrition. And yeah, it's going to be 4 turns to get Celestial Dragon Guard. So yeah, we've really got to keep... we've got to be careful, basically, against Tsinch. Because it seems fighting Tsinch is going to have like a minimum amount of damage we'll take. Just because their spells can just like delete units. So, it might be a case of, sadly, right? If we're actually on the ropes against Tsinch, the case might be just to auto-resolve instead of fighting it ourselves, because fighting ourselves actually leads to a greater cost because they could just wipe out a unit, whereas auto-resolve will spread the damage out. So it's a bit rubbish, honestly, that that's the case, but, you know. Also, we've ruined our harmony. So I'm just going to demolish that, because we don't need it. Next, I guess we'll go for the Hellcade Drove, and then we'll go to the Volery. Brilliant. So, Sentinel Technician, minus 10% upkeep for Terracotta Sentinel units, which is quite nice. This one has been trained the incantations needed to unlock the secrets of the Terracotta Sentinels, that they may always be primed and ready to strike on a battle with the Terracotta Sentinel unit. And a Silk Weaver, we've got a lot of those. And a Snake, and a Water Snake Breeder, we've got one of them too. Quicksilver Armor, that's nice. Its iridescent alloy plates flow fluidly over one another, lending power and grace to the wearer, yet hardening instantaneously at the point of contact. Good to know. Can't get evasion yet, need to do more things. Flash to Stone is quite fun. It's physical resistance now. Which won't help us against any of the demon units, because they... Like, all of the actual demon units, not all the things in the demon rosters, because, you know, like, marauders aren't demons, but everything that's actually a demon has magic damage, which ignores physical resist. So that doesn't help us against demons at all. Storm of Shadows, though, we got to slow enemies down, it's quite cool. Let's do that, then evasion, then we get Talons of Night.
The Bastion's defense requires it.
Okay, now for you, let's get something. Yes. I don't know, earthing, so you can overcast stuff if need be. I don't feel like we're ever doing that, but that's fine. Can we get something for one turn? Or something in one turn? We certainly can. We can get a Sky Lantern. Or some Jade Lances, maybe? I don't know. Maybe just get some more Jade Warrior Crossbowmen. I feel like we should get something. Let's get Jade Warrior with Halberds. I just want to make sure we're running at full, at full capacity. Oh, you have another level up. I didn't even realize. Sorry. Sorry, my man. Let's get you Wind Harmony, so you have some spell resistance. Good. Also, my word, I just realized we defeated Kairos before. That gave us like a, was it 15 or 20% spell resistance, was it? Yeah, 15% spell resistance for the whole army against Tsinchian factions. So we had like an entire unit wiped out by a single spell cast. And that was with some resistance as well. Which is mad. Really impressive. Tsinch is no joke, it would seem. Is he a nice high level? They get like a bunch of spell mastery and all sorts. So it's pretty crazy. Okay, so you're done there. I'm going to destroy this camp, I think, and then head north. We're going to try and get rid of these rifts. Do you want to get rid of the camp? I mean, do we have to? All of these are fully stocked. They're all walled. They're all walled settlements, so it's not like over here where they could just walk in. We all have walled settlements, so we can actually funnel the enemies in properly. Get some damage in with the outer towers. This is a problem, though. Once again, they have too much corruption for us to be able to move through their territory. Our brother's terrible at this. You know, he might close these, which is fine, but I need to get to our own. Because as you can see, from all the insane crystals growing everywhere, that Tsinch is really leaving an impression. Also, the map, isn't it stunning how it does this? I love it. It looks so good. Just amazing, like, visual indication. It's a lot better than just sort of, like, the ground getting a bit muddy looking, which seemed to be the vampiric corruption in the past. I don't know if they've updated vampiric corruption, actually. It's over here. Still looks much the same, but more cobwebs, maybe? Possibly more cobwebs and things. Oh, and more of these little things. That's definitely some weird necromantic nonsense. That's okay. They have some corn corruption over here, too. And some Slaanesh corruption. Wow, this place is a mess. Oh, well, that means the cobwebs aren't... Oh, no, that's vampiric corruption 100. Okay. So that is apparently nothing to do with vampiric corruption. I think there are just some areas like this thing that just exist on the map because it's Sylvania. But okay, sure. Kind of hard to tell, then. Never mind. Back to the capital. Whee! I love the capital button. It's cute. Okay, so the Volery we'll take. Should we actually take the Volery, or... I think we should take this next turn. Wojtek Helcade drove. If we take the Volery, that's their capital gone, and that's probably where they can recruit most things. So that will really screw them. And I like really screwing them. I will build a garrison here. Not because I'm keeping this place, but because if I build a garrison there, it's going to be harder for anyone to take it from behind us. So it, you know, we can leave it there and it'll get taken when it gets taken, and that's fine. But it'll help delay any empire up there sort of regrowing their ranks, which will be incredibly nice. So Grout is here. Can I assassinate anyone? Do you have anybody? No, you don't. But I can get Clog here. So, oh, nope, you're still exhausted for another turn. I don't want to have her run in with a tiny chance of assassination. Seems like a waste. Alright, you stay where you are, I suppose. This place is starting to clean up. Which is interesting. God, I love how the different corruptions actually impact stuff slightly differently. I think it's really interesting. Okay. I think we're good. I think we're done. Hero not moved. I know, she wasn't supposed to. Oh, they were supposed to move, though. I knew I was forgetting something. There's another rift up here that we haven't looked at. And it's sliming up the place.
You have the Celestial Emperor's favor.
And defensive alliance with Ungrim. I would, seeing as how he's actually got a proper empire, he's really growing. He's doing brilliantly. Like, he'll be in the mountains of Morn soon. That's amazing. Good for you, Ungrim. Good for you. This really is his time to shine, though. You know, him with his Slayer cult running around, killing demons and such. They're really in their element. I'm sure he's getting a lot of new recruits during this time, this tumultuous time. So yeah, let's get defensive alliance with him, and I reckon we'll get access to some pretty good units from him. Because it'd be great just to, like, borrow some artillery from him or something, you know? I think it'd be really cool. Like, God, can you imagine a Cathay army with organ guns? Ah, it'd be so good. So there are rumours of a quicker way through the mountains to ensure the merchandise reaches the markets quicker. But to turn rumour into reality, the guides demand a share of the profits. Yeah, might as well. Entrepreneurs take chances, agree to the profit share, and see us reach the markets before our rivals. Sounds good. Celestial Storm got destroyed and Harmony's balanced again. Good. Good, 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 good.
Child of the Nine.
Alright, you go deal with that. Jiangshi still has slots that we're not going to be using. Close that rift. Kill these Nurgle demons. Lovely garden. I'm sure they really love it here. And then let's venerate. Good. Now you are going to run all the way back to Turtlegate, where you're going to turtle. Like a gate. No, like a turtle. This one's fingers move as delicately as worms who make the silk with which they work. Alright, let's grab that. I still can't move south and take this over, can I? Or can I? I really don't know. I guess I'm just going to have to move south and see. See if we can... We have great line of sight. I mean, we might be able to get to Yeti Park. Welcome to Yeti Park. God, we're only on tier 1 on this place. It's pretty bleak. So what we're going to do, we're going to get the replenishment one. Again. And then we're going to demolish this building. Brilliant. We don't need it. We don't need it.
Celestial
still attrition over here, so we're going to have to go slow. Or do we? This is too slow. You know what? I'm just going to absorb the attrition. That's fine. It's not that big attrition. Maybe we can lower it a bit. You have a silk weaver? You don't. Everyone's got a silk weaver. Everybody. Everyone and mum. Also, why isn't Warrant of Trade equipped to anyone? I never equipped that on our bloody trader, did I? Oh, I'm a lunatic. Right, who is it? Power is it you? It is you. Alright, mate, come on. Warrant to trade. Let's get that, yeah? No, we have... Oh, we have a silk weaver there. That's nice. Don't need the razor standard. Warrant of trade. There we go. Income for trade faction-wide plus 20%. We're going to be on, like... Yeah, over 7k. Hell yeah.
The dragon blooded.
Can't believe that, though. Can't believe I forgot to equip that. Such an amazing bonus. And I was so in... Oh, hang on. And more trade goods. Screw it. So yeah, I think Volery is where we're going. We've taken a bunch of damage, but... Well... Oh, a bunch of damage, huh? It's fine. We'll deal with it. Okay, we're going to wipe out a faction. It's going to be great. If we auto-resolve, we can just kill them. Which seems a bit of a waste. But I mean, they have a Herald of Tzeentch, and they have an Iridescent Horror of Metal. So none of them, they're both fresh off the boat. So none of them have like crazy good stuff, though they do have an Exalted Flamer, Tzeentch, and a Lord of Change. The Lord of Change actually does have a couple of good spells too. I was gonna say they're fresh off the boat, so I can just have Miao Yin hop over the fence and murder the crap out of them. But if they've got a Exalted Flamer of Tzeentch with 1.5k missile strength and a Lord of Change, that is a Lord of Change, fighting with them, then maybe I can't just hop over, kill the spellcasters and march in. So we may have to be a little more careful than that. But yeah, I think we have to fight it. This is probably the last battle we'll have against Kairos's army, because for some reason the Poxmakers of Nurgle still haven't made a move. Like, they're still nowhere. They're still nowhere. We only have 11 turns left to get jump into a portal and start soul claiming, but very bizarre. Anyway, let's fight these guys. Alright, here we are. Lovely chaos-themed horrible wasteland city. Yeah, brilliant. Some ancient civilization of man. Or perhaps it was built by demons or something. Who really knows? I certainly don't. But yeah, really cool. I just love the ancient architecture in ruins. Very cool. Very, very cool. We did kind of see some hint at similar architecture in the first soul collected cutscene, you know, where we had Bellicor sat at the top of that tower that looks very reminiscent of this sort of thing. It feels like a lot of this is whatever empire he had crafted, you know, which is very cool. I really like that as a thing. Back when building an empire across the world was sort of something demons did before they just sort of turned up every now and then. Against the advice of the Vortex, you know? They had a more sort of permanent home here once upon a time. Could we stop that? Because, yeah, this stuff doesn't really get the tender love and care that it needs anymore. Probably for the best, for us mortal folk. Okay, let's get you over here, let's get you over there. I also love that's, like, the amount of stuff that you can just sort of confer from like, the world. I think it's great. But you guys have mad range, huh? Wait, what has mad range? Oh, pink. It's because it's pink auras. Yeah, okay. Well, this is going to sting. It's going to sting a lot. My test begins. An awful lot. Let's do a lightning over here. Or we do a Comet Cassandor over here. Yeah, the amount of stuff you can confer in this. I only got rid of the barrier. God, it's just... Tzeentch's barriers are so good. They really are amazing. They're so useful. Alright, it's going to spawn you over here. Yeah, look at that. Barrier just deflects most of the damage. It really is incredible. So useful. But luckily, we're all in range of our missiles now. We can do some mad damage. Don't know what to hit next, though. Alright. I guess they've decided there's no way they can hold this. Which is good. Good for us. Now, let's get you over here so we can pin them in place, shall we? Ooh, Doom Knights. And they have the Iridescent Horror. That's also on a chariot. I love how the garrison actually changes mount options now for the heroes. Heroes are so much better now, seriously. They're great. And okay, those Forsaken are happy to sit there, are they? My mind is ready. I mean, I'm happy if you are. We can't reach them, sadly. Alright, that's fine. So there's the Doom Knights. Let's debuff the crap out of them. Oh, no, don't, no, stay down, stay down. Oh, good, good, they stayed down. We managed to pin them down. Phew. Wind and fire. That'd be really sad if they managed to get up. And now, I think I might Comet Cassandor over here. Although I think lightning might just be better. Yeah, we are doing a number on them, as it is, so yeah, we're fine. But I will do lightning here. Yeah, those Doom Knights are no joke, though. They're very powerful. Although, we are really getting through them. Wow. Yeah, we really got through them in a hurry. I mean, it certainly helped that these guys were overwatching, but my god, they did not last. And we're not going to last against this sort of assault either. Are you guys through yet? Oh my god, you are. Oh, go kill everything. Good boys. Good boys. Alright, let's put you on guard mode. You can start firing at them. Same with you lot. You can start firing at them. You guys are going to climb. Because I know you're all just going to be climbing up random ladders if I try and push you all through anyway. There's still a lot to contend with here. But I think we'll be okay. We got our Demogryph Knights. They're trying to hit us with their piercing bolts. Come on, move. Move. They're not moving. Okay, what are you all doing? Come on, I put you on guard mode. It should be evident that I don't want you just, like, chasing enemies down like that. Seriously. Okay. They can't make up their mind what they're doing here. Hopefully they'll land. Excellent, they've landed. No, they haven't. Okay, fine. Wish they'd make their mind up. Really wish they'd make their mind up. And, oh, that is going to sting like hell. Okay, Lord of Change has landed. Let's get him. Let's get him. Debuff like mad. And Comet Cassandora on top of them. Should do the job. And yeah, that's going to sting. That's going to sting, alright. Alright, let's get over here too. Actually, go for that Exalted Flavor of Siege. The anti-large that we have on our Demogryph Knight should be able to absolutely wreck that guy. Alright, come on guys, keep moving. Come on guys. Oh, you get so confused for so long. And, they're breaking their way through. Alright, we'll retreat. We'll retreat with them, it's fine.
Immediately, raise the dragons.
Okay, you guys get down here, please. And go kill this iridescent horror, if you would. Lord of Change. Actually, he's decided to come and fight Demigryphs. I'm fine with that, actually. I am fine with that. Oh my god, really? Come back here. His speed is 85, ours is 84. Oh, never mind then. Forget that. Exalted Flamer time. Alright, come on, guys. Come on. Come on. Terracotta Sentinels, you really can't move them as a pack. They just bump into each other. They bump into each other and it goes all wrong. Oh. It decided to attack us, did it? Alright, go for the Exalted Flamer now. Attaboy.
Moving now! My girl, Maras!
You missed. You missed, guys. You missed. Alright, we'll keep chasing. Alright, they have a Lord there. Let's chase him down. Almost got the Lord of Change. Oh, nice. Oh, that is how it's done. Yeah, you splat that. You splat that, boy. Alright, come on. Oh, don't get shot. Don't get shot by him. Come on. Okay, let's go handle them. You can stay in here. Actually, you guys, I do want you to move up. Come have a kill this Exalted Flamer. Good. Now you lot, I suppose, need to catch up, don't you? You sure do. You sure do. Alright. Whoops. That was incorrect. Alright, no, we're doing well. We're doing well. I almost got that flamer. And no, thank you. No, you keep moving. God, I hate when units are just like slightly squiffy. You know, there's like one guy. Like a straggler. Because I ended up dragging the Celestial Dragon Guard back into that. By accident. Also, how did they get that spell? Is that a bound spell? Maybe that's a bound spell now. Because I'm pretty sure that guy's just metal. Lore of Metal. And so is this guy, right? He's also Lore of Metal. So the Lord of Change had something. So yeah, that specific ability must be one of the their army abilities. I didn't realize. It must be one of the higher level ones. Because they do have a spell that's basically that, so. Okay, so we're doing 899 damage per hit, which is pretty impressive. The Demogryph Knight's been doing quite well. 1,000 gold value? I mean, that's not the best, actually. But it's not terrible. For the Helden Hammer. I love that they're, like, still on Team Sigma, you know, despite the fact they're fighting for us. I really love that. Feels very cool. Yeah, still representing their emperor. Very, very cool. Alright, you keep moving up. And there we go. There's army losses. Phew. That was a grind. Very fun, though. Oh, just look at this. So good. Yeah, they really did do the Chaos Waste justice. It looks amazing. Pyrrhic victory. Okay, we didn't lose anyone this time, though we definitely could have done. Jesus. A lot of experience. Nice. And even if we do occupy this, all it's going to do is shelter us from attrition. It's not even going to give us any... Is yeah, replenishment rate minus 15%. I'm not sure we'll even be able to... Their coin is cast. Yeah, I don't know. Let's get rid of that. And we can demolish that too. And this one, I don't know, should I repair it? Maybe I will. I'll build walls here, maybe. Although it will affect our harmony. So that's plus one yin. So I could leave that and just build the thing that does yang, but that's going to take 4 turns to build because we're in such terrible... Such a terrible, terrible place. So let's just burn it to the ground. And amazingly, we are actually getting some replenishment. That is surprising. Oh, another Sentinel Technician. Sealed Weaver Power Stone. Killed an enemy. Sure did. Yeah, we're just going to destroy everything.
Ready to defend.
Excellent. Right, now I want to check. Reichland, 33. We're on 33. What do we need again for the... We need 45. We're getting there. We're getting there, guys. Just you wait. So, 2 more skill points, which means Talons of Night we can max out. Can't wait to see this in action.
I was born to wield it.
And Yutang Nanman can get something, I guess. spread control. Cheer everyone up.
Storm Dragon.
Keep everyone happy. They can take more turns to build this.
I stand apart.
And Skaldir Doomfoe. I don't think is friendly. Bang on. Are you going to destroy... If this guy attacks Hellcade Drove and destroys that, that'd be so funny. Kairos defeated by some, like, corn fanatic. Although, they do still have this army, which has a couple of Exalted Flamers, some Flamers, Screamers, Doom Knights. Jesus. Sorry, they don't have Jesus. Imagine if Jesus was in his army. It's like, how did I get here?
Dragon-blooded Shugunga.
You'd be great. Right, you can do this with good odds now, right? You can, 67%.
Me.
I don't know, I think they do expect you. You've been murdering everybody. Yeah, there we go. More murder. You're getting very good at murdering. I am going to give you a warhorse. I think it's only fair that you, you know, traipse around the Mountains of Mord on a horse. There you go. Also, hang on a minute. Where was that? Equipment gained. Equipment gained. Why are there 2 separate tabs for equipment gained? Oh well. Warhorse. I really love this write-up. So, General's horse can be his most trusted and daring companion. Just don't name him Daisy. Daisy is a reference to... God, what was it? Marius Lightdorf's horse? So Marius Lightdorf? I'm pretty sure it's Marius Lightdorf. Pretty sure. I'm so bad with names. Anyway, the Elect Count of Avalon. His whole character is that he's mad. He's Marius the Mad. Hang on, is it Marius the Mad? I'm thinking it's not Marius. I'm thinking Marius Lightdorf might be another elect account. Whatever the case, the Avalon elect account, he's crazy. And he has a horse named Daisy that he holds in very high regard, even taking orders from him, from the horse. So, you know, declare war. Things like that, the horse will say, that river needs fighting, and he'll declare war on a river and command his troops to attack the river. It's very strange. They have sort of changed his character over the years a bit, but there's still a lot of like legacy stories of him just being completely mad. So he's interesting. But he did die at the Battle of Blackfyre Pass that Karl Franz took part in. The Orc war boss killed him ahead of Calfrans. Kind of getting, I guess, like possessed by Sigma and
loyalty,
killing the war boss.
And harmony.
So, you know, it's all good. All's well that ends well. Except he definitely died, which I guess isn't a great ending for him. But anyway, right.
Dragon-blooded Shugungun.
What next?
Dragon-blooded Shugungun.
Dragon-blooded Shugungun.
Shugungun Lord reporting.
Oh, she said something different. I was expecting her to say, Dragon-blooded Shugungun. Could definitely make a remix out of that. Okay, I guess missile resist, why not?
It
I don't
befits
know.
My high station.
And for you, more Gehenna's Golden Hounds. We're going to get all the hounds.
Power in the blood.
Okay, good. Good, good, good. Alright, we're doing well. Still don't know where we're travelling to. I was really expecting to be in the Realms of Chaos by now.
Glory.
But I'll take it. So Mist Gorge, yeah, we want this built before we do anything. We really do the replenishment before we start moving about again. Don't want to get caught out again. I also kind of want Mist Gorge to get leveled up. So Mist Gorge, it is going to level up pretty quickly. We should get growth. Well, not growth. We should get population surplus in quite quickly because we have decent growth from our gates and Jade Blooded... Temple of the Jade Blooded Sorcerers as well. So we got some options. So where are we going to build this? Oh my god, we could get gyrocopters. We could get gyrocopters to support. So we could have basically an army of gyrocopters and sky junks. So we could have a bunch of balloons and helicopters and stuff. We could have like a whole air force. I mean, I say that. We'll be limited to 4 of these per army, but I mean, sounds amazing, right? So why is Carrick Vlag the only place I can build one? Oh, right, yeah, because you can only build one per thing. I'm sure Carrick Kadrin already has something there, so we'll go Carrick Vlag. I mean, it's a great selection here. We get slayers as well, some long beards, some artillery. Hopefully they'll keep developing that, and the fact they got grudge throwers means they're probably going to keep building up that chain. So this is awesome. Oh, I'm so happy. I love this mechanic, I really do. I imagine taking like a bunch of brimstone guns into hell where they belong. You know, a lot of brimstone in hell. So it depends what flavor of hell we're going in, really. So anyway, that's all good, and that's the end of the turn. Let's go. Settlement transferred. Oh my god, are you joking? This is insane. We're not at war with Loose Tooth. So we can't even take Mist Gorge back. Oh my god, now we're not in harmony. Seriously, like, I cannot believe how actively they are screwing us here. Also, how can they afford it? Like, seriously, how can they afford it? They have nothing. Oh my god, there's a big army showing up these days, huh? So this we're gonna just leave, I suppose. Wait, what? I didn't even see that there was anything in that building slot. That's very strange. Okay. I think I might have tried to destroy it and I clicked repair instead. I don't know. But anyway, the change of ways moves against you. Tzigian agents have manipulated the populace of Mist Gorge. They've switched allegiances to their new masters, Loose Tooth. Will you let this outrage stand? I just don't know how they managed that at all. And yeah, we are going to have a rebellion here, like, obviously. And now we're in Young Harmony, which is and bye.
Erect a shrine to our
And, okay, they're spawning armies.
Only the changer.
Well, this is getting annoying. This is getting annoying. Demons everywhere. Bloody demons. So now, do I even want this? I have no idea. Do I want this? Why haven't you done anything here? Okay, so they knackered this place and didn't actually commit. So, who are you?
You're gonna feed my hunger.
I mean, maybe. They hate me. I mean, they absolutely hate me, so maybe we will feed their hunger by declaring war on them. Yeah, I think we'll just declare war on them. Like, whatever.
Celestial ancestors.
This isn't a problem. Alright, done. Oh my god, if I auto-resolve, I'm gonna lose a bunch of units? I'll do it anyway. We're gonna be loitering here for a while anyway. Once again, let's try to get to rank 2. To tier 2.
child.
Okay, good.
The
and then let's get. I mean, I could upgrade a bit
Service
and go for some Celestial Dragon Guard. But I think it might be a bit much. Alright, now where are you going to go? I guess you head down here and see who you can assassinate. It does seem that Grisus is having a bit of trouble with all the Chaos Agents running around. Mountains of Morn have definitely looked better. They've definitely looked better. Okay. Now, we need to work out what we're doing, Miao Yin. I guess if we move here, we'll be better off, but it's hard to say. Slightly better. Slightly better spot. So, I'm going to move here. This guy will probably try and attack us. I don't know. We'll figure it out. We'll be fine. This isn't so bad, because we don't have to worry about spells. So we can just put our healthiest units in the front and murder them all with a hail of arrow fire. So, you know, or bolt fire, I suppose. I don't suppose we could just ask you politely to go destroy Hellcade Drove, huh? Yeah, probably not. I don't think they're interested. So that'll do. So anyway, guys, we're at the end of the turn and the end of the episode once again. So guys, if you enjoyed this, comment, like, subscribe. I'll see you the next one. Take care, guys.